three of your brother deacons who happened to be on the ceremony this morning and your bishop all grew up on the south side of Chicago. I grew up in a home that was just a little bit more than a block away from St. Nick's Church and St. Nicholas Grammar School. And my dad, who was a streetcar man, which he liked, later a bus driver, which he hated, worked funny hours to make more money. He'd go to bed early and get up real early and work all those hours, but come home at noon, and our main meal was at noon. And in those days, almost everyone went home for lunch. And it was a rather pleasant experience. We had an aunt who lived with us for a while, my mother's father lived with us. Kind of fond memories of those midday meals. But one day the meal was over, went in to use the bathroom before I headed off to school, and I couldn't get the door open afterwards. So my mom's outside the door screaming. Eventually my dad comes, "What did you do?" The usual stuff. And he finally goes around to the gateway between our house and house next door. Somehow he talked me out of standing in the bathtub, got the screen off the window, and unhooked the screen, and kind of hung out, and he said, "Danny, jump." Well, I hesitated for a moment. Then he said, "Danny, jump." And I jumped. And of course, he caught me in his arms. And I went off to school. God knows how he got that door open later, but he did. If we grow up in a stable family, we know our dads are going to catch us. I don't want this to sound too idyllic. In my teenage years, we had a kind of cold war between my starting college papa and my would-be son. But I always knew he would be there, that there would be food on the table. He cared what I did in school, that I was not to get in trouble. He was a presence that you could bank on with your life. Kids need it. Doesn't always happen, but it's necessary. When Jesus, in today's gospel, allows the little children to come to him, and obviously they were not afraid of him, and then he touches them and holds them, he's giving us all a message, one that is really, in many ways, unique. Jesus revealed God as an Abba, God as a Papa, God as a Dad. Israel often called God the Father, but with enormous, almost fearful reverence. God's explicit name, Yahweh, I am the one who is, was so holy that after the passage of time, only the high priest could pronounce that name, and then only once a year. And it was an event when he announced the name Yahweh. All the priests would fall on their faces. The court of Israel, where all the men were, fell on their faces. The court of the women, everyone put their face on the ground. And that spread into Jerusalem at the same time. And even out in the diaspora, outside the Holy Land, people kind of calculated when that moment would be. So from Babylon, Rome, Spain, devout Jews fell upon their faces in awe before the name of the Lord. And Jesus grew up in a temple observant family, and he certainly had awe for God and his Father. But he introduced that family, that diminutive name, that name of great confidence, Abba. As deacons, as priests, as your worthy servant, the bishop, we need to be able to come to Jesus, who is God's Son, with that same absolute trust. I don't know about you, but I waste a lot of time worrying about things I have no control over, or I've messed up, or I don't know what to do. In the cathedral rectory next door, there are nights, Wednesday, deacons, Friday, where I'm kind of crashing and turning, staring at this. scared, anxious, worrisome. That's what I need to remember, that we are to be childlike in our approach to God. That doesn't mean irresponsible babies. There was a great scripture scholar, Monsignor Ives, who said, babies are loud at one end and irresponsible on the other. Kids are perfect, but a screaming baby, that baby is born into a loving family, knows someone cares when they scream. And children know that good parents will be there for them. And us as believers, and all of us, you know, the priests don't stop being deacons when they're ordained priests, and your bishop doesn't stop being a priest or a deacon when I was ordained a bishop, but all of us need to trust Him, willingly surrender our lives.